My name is Courtney Middelkoop. I recently graduated in December of 2019 with my master's in industrial engineering. What made me look into Iowa State is they had a gymnastics team, and I had grown up doing club gymnastics all my life, and I wanted to pursue that in college. And I also found out they had an industrial engineering program. So one reason why I started looking into industrial engineering is because my dad is also a fellow industrial engineer. And so every day after work, he'd come home and kind of tell me what he was doing throughout the day. And it really seemed cool to try to eliminate all those non-value-added tasks that companies do and try to improve their processes. And that's kind of when I figured out what I wanted to do, and I wanted to be an industrial engineer. Once I got on campus at Iowa State, I knew it was a perfect fit for me. The coaches on the gymnastics team were great. Everyone in the industrial engineering program was very welcoming. And I've loved my adventure at Iowa State ever since. And I'm glad to continue it with my grant I got with the IMSE department, and I'll be helping the senior design capstone team implement remote monitoring for their manufacturing companies so the students are able to finish their capstone projects without ever having to step foot into a manufacturing facility. KOOP is a remote engineering consulting service that provides a convenient and innovative solution to help companies improve their organization. We observe their processes to find ways to reduce waste and unnecessary time, improve methods, and minimize hand and body movements. Kind of the progress and timeline of my business was about 2 years ago when me and my dad were kind of brainstorming of how we could actually improve the industrial engineering process. So we came up with the out-of-the-box creative solution, and that was KOOP. Once I had that business idea, I was not sure where to go next with it, and I had learned that there was an entrepreneurial class offered through the IMSC department. So I took that actually in grad school, and the professors for that class were Jim Fay and Dave Sly, and they made a great impact in me in the entrepreneurial spirit, and it really gave me a foundation to which to grow upon. Later on that summer, I actually was in the Iowa State pitch competition where I pitched my business model and idea in front of Iowa State fairgoers. That experience really got me out of my comfort zone, and it was probably one of my favorite things I've done at Iowa State. So some of my favorite courses in the industrial engineering department was IE 222 with Leslie Potter. It's really great to see a strong and powerful woman in engineering, and it kind of inspired me moving forward in my career. Also IE 271 with Dr. Stone, looking at ergonomics and applying those in the workforce. That's what made me want to start my master's program and focus in human factors and ergonomics. And then once in grad school, I really loved the engineering management courses that Mike Helwitt taught. It gave you a better understanding of how business is actually done and working with people. So it gave you that business aspect to the engineering. Having a business idea, I wasn't quite sure where to start. So I looked into Iowa State and what they had to offer. One thing that I found was the IE 434X with Jim Fay and Dave Slide, where I was actually able to put some of my thinking process and ideas to work. From there, I was able to do a pitch competition at the Iowa State Fair, where I pitched in front of Iowa State fairgoers, and that really got me out of my comfort zone. And also great resource at Iowa State is the John and Mary Papa John Center, where I met Judy Isles, and they're running a great program there, and I know they have some SciStarters opportunities for you to improve your growth as an entrepreneur in your company. There's a lot of great resources at Iowa State, and it seems like it's growing even more, especially with the Student Innovation Center, and I'm excited to see what comes out of that building.